Today I've got three hostess gifts that they're gonna love. Keep watching. I'm Brandy and this is Making It My Own DIYs. Welcome to the Southern Holly Jolly Soiree. Join me and my friends today for some crafting ideas and a giveaway. So I went to the thrift store and collected a couple of these beautiful boards. They are cutting boards, bread boards, charcuterie boards, whatever you want to call them, cheese and cracker boards, but they're in pathetic shape, especially this one. And man, the turnabout is wonderful on these, especially that really crusty one. I'm going to take my power saw, but you can use a rough grit sanding block if you would like. Take them outside, give them a good old sanding. Now, everything is not going to be removed from it, obviously. I don't want to do that because I like rustic, so the little cutting marks and the little chop marks are completely fine for me. Be sure that you give these a good wipe down because there's a lot of dust that remains on there. You might not see it, but I guarantee you'll see it on your cloth. You can already see it on that cloth. So once it's all wiped down, going to protect your surface, and we're going to start working on these to give them a better coloring. And look at this. This is antique wax, y'all. The Waverly antique wax. Look what it did. Beautiful. So I'll show you here on the back exactly what I did. I'm just going to take a brush and just start smearing it on there. It's thick. It's a thick texture. So just get it on the board really well, and I'm just smearing it all around there, not trying to make it look pretty and my brush is falling apart, but yeah, not worried about that. Just getting it on there is the main thing, and then we're going to be wiping it off. So I've got some fresh paper towels, but you can use cheesecloth, you can use an old rag, an old t-shirt, I understand works really well for this. And we're just going to start rubbing in circles and rubbing around and around, covering all of our surfaces and just really rubbing it into the wood. Can you believe that was underneath the nastiness on that board? I picked the board up because of the shape, but man, I am super thrilled with this. Look at that. Yeah, this one is a stunner. Love it. Don't pass these up when you're at the thrift store. Be sure you get around all your edges with your wax and the little hole up there. I'm not going to make a hanger for mine. I'm going to leave that open to you, but you know, do what you need to do. And I'm just going to show you here what you would want to do if you were using your sanding block. Just going back over some of these deeper cut marks and just smoothing the edges down. Now, these are not going to be something that are food safe. This is a project that I'm doing because I like to use these as decor pieces. And I think that whoever receives these as gifts will also like these as decor pieces. So see there, this is why we have to wipe them down. Nice clean surface before you put your wax or your tints or stains on your items. So now I'm going to use this clear wax and start putting this on. I started off with one of my chippy brushes because I have several of these and thought that this might be a good way to lay this down. I'm just going with the direction of the wood grain itself, and you can already see as it starts to soak in the difference in the wood that's not conditioned with wax and the side that is conditioned with wax. So I'm just going to continue along here and make sure I cover my surface. Also get the sides, like I said before, and this brush is just not good for doing those narrow surfaces. So I'll be switching that over to a sponge brush. This comes in a pack from Dollar Tree. And you can just use that to apply that on the sides, and this works fantastic. So I just go ahead and use this all over the sides, just really conditioning and focusing on getting that into the grain of the wood. And then I'm gonna flip it over and we're gonna do the back as well. And see the difference there, the before and after. Really nice. You could even do this with an old cutting board maybe you have at home that you don't use anymore and you wanna use it for decoration. You could certainly just go ahead, sand it, clean it, sand it, wipe it, and then condition it. Now this is a pine board that had something painted on it, and I took that off and do not have footage of that for you, but you get the idea. I find these types of things in the thrift store all the time. So I'm gonna take some of this gray tint, and this is also a product that Plaid sent me. Loving using all these waxes and wood tints. It does not have an odor, so the stains that you would normally use, or maybe you would normally use it, I'm not sure what you would normally use, but the stains that you have to take outside, they are really strong scented and they're just really not good for anybody with the respiratory problems. So this is a really good alternative. I'm just using a baby wipe on my finger and just rubbing this into this pine piece. I love the raw edge on this board. It's really pretty, and we're going to make something very nice with this. You can see the difference. And then, of course, after this is all done, we're going to be giving it a coat of wax too, to seal it and make it look pretty. Now, if you chose to use these boards as charcuterie boards after you get them, or cracker boards, cheese boards, what have you, you would need to put something down on top of it to separate your food from your board. So maybe some wax paper or something like that underneath it. But like I said, this is something that I use in my home for decoration, and I think anybody who loves like a farmhouse rustic feel in their home would like to have something like this just to use as a decor in their kitchen. Maybe there are some open shelves above their above the cabinets. I have that up there, and that's where I display a lot of things, and it's really pretty in a place like that or on some open shelves, whichever way. Now I'm going to get in the sides too with this and just kind of dab that in there so that we have some continued color. And I'm just choosing to leave the back of mine plain just to save on product, but you would definitely want to do your entire product if you're going to give this away. I do glue that back down with some wood glue, a little splinter coming off there. That's the thing about pine bark. It's just real flaky and it'll just go all over the place. Got to be really careful with it. I'm just rubbing it into the grain there. You can see that beautiful grain. Okay, so if you wanted to do wooden spoons, I'm just throwing this in here. I didn't use it for this, but you could. Just go ahead and grab your wax and a baby wipe and just rub it into the little wooden spoons. Go ahead and sand that if you need to sand it. Just kind of feel it and use your own judgment of what you want to do. Again, this is going to be something that will be decoration. It's not going to be food safe. So you don't want to be cooking with this or mixing up your cookies or anything with it. But they look really pretty in a crockery or in a white pitcher, something like that, just for display. Really, really pretty. And these are so cheap. You can get wooden spoons and wooden pieces at the Dollar Tree. Really save yourself some money. So this is how it looks after, and then I'll show you what the spoons look like before, just for a little difference there, so you can see the difference. Okay, so back to this beautiful board. I have let it sit for 24 hours with the wax on it, and now I'm just going to use a clean cloth and just buff up the wax. Just buffing it in, massaging it in circles all over this now gorgeous piece of wood. I think my appreciation for wood came from the fact that my dad is in the lumber business, and he was always making things. He doesn't do it as much now that he's retired, I don't believe, but yeah. And then now on this other one, same thing. We're gonna buff it out really, really well, and it's gonna bring a little shine back to this wood. It's going to make it look nice and rich. Excuse my head. I had to get my camera up high. Y'all know the routine. You know how it goes. And I'm absolutely wearing my pajamas in this video. Okay, so we're going to go around the edges too and just buff that out. And you can see the difference in this piece. I love the cut marks in there. I love that it appears to have had a life before it came to me. And I like that. I like the age look. Now you can see a little sheen in there. Beautiful, beautiful. I love that. Love it. So now we're going to take that other piece and we're going to wax it. I'm using a little more of this translucent or clear wax on here. And just go all over here. And I use this one instead of the foam brush this time because I want to be sure that I can get in the edge of the bark that is on the side. Just like that. So that helps to keep that wood nice and safe conditioned and so that it won't have any continued flaking on it. It'll dry clear, so that won't be a problem. And then you just buff it out, just like we did the other pieces. I'm just pressing it down. It's kind of rough on the edges, even when you sand it. When you do the grain like that, it's kind of rough. Follow me on my social media, Pinterest, Facebook, and Instagram. Now it's time for decorating. So I've just taken this branch that I have had for several years and usually have on my mantle. And I'm going to just fold this over and let it appear as though it is hanging down. I have two little star cookie cutters, which also have been in my Christmas things for many years. I'm going to use them again and give them some new life. I'm going to take a piece of this jute and just cut it. And then we're going to tie these together, layered just like this. I think it gives a nice look. And if you gave it as a gift, someone could certainly remove that and use it to make their own cookies. Just going to give it a little knot down there to hold them together. And then we'll tie it to the stem because I don't want to put any staples or glue on this board. And I don't know that glue would work very well anyway because it is waxed. I'm just kind of tucking this cord around it, twisting it back to the front, and then tying it. You can certainly make a bow. You can put a ribbon here. You can put some berries on the top, whichever way you want to do it. But I like the simplicity of the piece just like this. Now, one more piece under here to keep it from slipping because I'm not going to be gluing that stem and it can slip off those rounded edges. I'm just going to tuck a piece of this jute around here and tie it off in the back just in a double knot and then trim it down. And if you tuck it nicely into the branches, you will barely notice it. Sorry, I'm out of the camera angle there. But you see, it'll stay there nicely. Wow, what a difference from the way that this sad board looked in the very beginning. It looked like it had bleach on it or some type of an acid. It was awful. Now it's beautiful and rustic. Now we're going to make a gift basket with this tall one. So I have this rabbit. This is like a cooler bag for or a cooler box for a bottle of wine. I got this at thrift store, brand new with the tag still in it. I also got these two little spatulas, also from the thrift store, new. And this little tree, also from the thrift store. And I don't know if it's new or not, but you know. And then I have this bucket that came from the thrift store. So I've saved a ton of money on this beautiful gift. I think the only thing that's going to cost anything that's worth it would be the bottle of wine that you place in there if you want to give that as part of your gift. So I'm just going to layer these in with the tallest in the back. I'm going to take some pillow stuffing or batting or fake snow, whatever you have. You can also use paper shreds in here if you would like. Just tuck it around so your things aren't shifting all over the place. It makes a nice presentation as well. This will give it some height for the shorter pieces too. I'm going to add my little tree in here. Tuck the spatulas right in the back. I love that there are deer on there, so pretty. Then I have a little basket. I'm going to make a little nest for my thrifted bird. And of course, we got to add a little something in there for the bird. And what a cute, cute gift. What a high-end looking gift. Nobody would know that these things came from the thrift store. Love it. Would you love getting a basket like that? I know I would. So, buffing out the wax just like we did on the other ones until it is perfect. And then we're going to do something a little bit different with this one as well. I wanted to give you three different ideas for three different types of people that you may be going to their home, and maybe they have cooked the meal and done all the work, and you've just shown up. So, a hostess gift is the perfect idea for those people who care enough to do all of that hard work. And let me tell you, it's a lot of work to cook for a lot of people. So we're going to take the ribbon, whichever you choose. Mine is wired. It does not matter on this project, but I think it definitely helped. You can see how I am wrapping this around. Mine came from Hobby Lobby and it's 50% off. I'm just going to turn it over on itself like this. You can see here. Turn it over, fold it down. Then I'm going to hold the board, turn it over. What I'm doing is figuring out how much of this ribbon I'm going to need before I cut it, and I don't want to make a bunch of cuts. Again, I want this to look high end. So I'm going to cross it over here. And then we're going to trim this down. I'm just trying to get this part straight because I am making a cross. I'm going to use my staple gun and just put a couple of staples to hold this ribbon in place. Again, I don't want to put glue on here, and you can easily remove staples and sand it down if you want to use it for something else. So now we have the beginnings of our cross. I'm going to take a scrap piece of ribbon that I have, and it just looks like, I think it's like a linen blend. And it's brown or beige. It matches nicely with this, and it has a little bit of a gold edge. I'm going to twist this across the middle. You can see what I'm doing here. Tuck it under. This is easier than I'm making it look. Okay, now you're going to adjust the little tie in the middle by just sliding your ribbon around. This is not wired and it does not need to be. And you can see you're just going to fool with it for just a minute until you get that nice looking in the middle. And you can do that by just pushing it around. Okay, and then when you have the little center of it looking like an X, then you have it the way you want it. You can go ahead and trim off your ribbon and then put your tie right there in the middle. So now you can stop here if you want to. It's beautiful. It's going to help be a reminder to the people in your family who need some hope and who are of the faith to have a little something in their home that is warm and reminds us of the reason for the season. But we're going to add a little bit more. I'm using Jingle Bell. They look like they're aged. They're kind of a crusty looking silver. These I got at Dirt Cheap a long time ago. And we're just going to put them all on one hanger or one little piece. It looks like fishing wire to me. We're going to use three of them. Wrap them around and around. You could glue if you want, but it'll pretty much melt this. But they will be secured to that board, so that will not be a concern. We're going to put them here. And then wrap that ribbon right through the center, and that's going to hold it in place. Now you can do more than one knot if you would like. You can trim off that ribbon if you would like, but I think that the ribbon looks pretty there as an extra little bit of layer and movement. And so that is the third one, and I think that it is very pretty. And very simple. These are projects you can definitely do. The most work you're going to have is the sanding. And then, of course, you have to let it wait in between to dry. But the payoff is worth it, I think. Because here are three hostess gifts that are just so pretty and thrifted. So they're inexpensive and I know I would like to have one of these as a gift, definitely. My brother made me a breadboard one year, and I absolutely love it. And then another year, he made a framed, I think it was a fleur-de-lis, and I still have those pieces. It means a lot when you have things that are handmade, you know, and that you put your work into and your imagination and effort into. And I think the people that love you and know you and care about you would absolutely love having something that you handcrafted. We don't have to spend a lot of money. It's the thought that counts.
And nobody wants to see their loved ones in debt at the holiday time. I know I don't. And I know my viewers don't. I'm so happy to have you here. I'm so glad that you stopped by. We're almost to the 9,000 mark, and then we'll be doing another giveaway. So stay tuned for that. Thanks for stopping by, and I'll see you again very soon. Bye.